Today's adventure brings me to this sink. As you can see, I turn him on, and he starts leaking. Right out of there. But the next thing that sucks is he's also leaking from over here. I hope you can see the water. And then he's getting down here all wet. So my project will be, I'm gonna get a new drain piece here, and I'm gonna see what I could do first before I do anything else with the sink right here. I'm gonna see if maybe I can just clean some stuff up, put it, if I might have an O-ring that fits, and fix it. Okay, so first we're taking this apart so we can fix this leak. Okay, that's the size. Hopefully everything comes apart. Hopefully I can just, ooh, nice. Hopefully all I have to do, oh, let's first, before we go this route. Box to keep children out, also keep me out. Okay, first I'm gonna turn the water off. Okay, water is off. Now come back up over here. Gotta get the handle off. But before we do that, let's get the pressure out. Okay. I got it to actually spin. I was expecting it to put a little fight. Put him back in. Don't want to lose him. This, I probably need a wrench or something. Get him. Section. Gotta get him off. Need a ratchet. Size this. Oh, too small. So it's an inch and an eighth.
But it works. So I see no reason. I'm getting rid of them. Loose, once anything loose, plumbing, just comes up. Oh, yeah, he's got some crud in there, so he'll have to get cleaned up. Now, the inner part comes out. Okay, he's all cruddy. He'll need to be cleaned up. And this is where my leak is. It's inside this. So there's my seals. So, I have these O-rings right here. I'm gonna take off, see if I clean them up a little. If my leak goes away. Hopefully it does. If not, I will get new O-rings. Now, I actually think just the top is. Yeah, they got top and bottom. And then this looks like a friction ring. Just like this friction ring came off just to allow them to slide. That's not sealing anything. Okay, hopefully I don't ruin the O-ring as I try to get it out. If I do, I have to run out and get a new one. But let's take him out. Come on out. Okay. He's out. Just a little grease. It could be good. Let's get the bottom one too. Then some in here. I don't know if the bottom or the top is the culprit, so we do both. Okay, I can't. I just need O-rings. Okay, here we go. Then slide them up. Don't go. Of course, you get stuck in the upper part. So we're just doing the same thing over again. You're coming all the way out without ripping or breaking. Okay, both of them are out. He doesn't look too damaged. Okay. Little friction ring on here, which allows the sink to turn. It's not a seal, it just lets the sink turn. Let's take him off. Let's spray him up real fast. A little sealant in this gasket. Looks like it will seal up perfectly. Is that a little damp? No. I didn't check it. Maybe I damaged him when I was moving him. But I think if I put some sealant on, he will be okay. Yeah, even this one. I'll see if I have them. If I have them, I'll swap them because they're inexpensive. But maybe just a little sealant and he's on his way. But being like, no more leaks. I'm gonna spray everything with WD. Spray them all clean. It takes it right off. I know. I want WD in my drinking water. This is above the drinking water. Drinking water goes there. If I flush it, the WD comes out anyway. It's my water, not yours. So you don't have to worry about it. You don't have to use WD. You use other cleaners. These gaskets look good, but I'm even going to put some sealant on this. I'm not a professional plumber. If I was, I would probably just swap this thing, 1, 2, 3, be done with it. I'm an air conditioning heating mechanic, and I like to dissect things that I don't work on every day and see how it works. You know, this is your switch. You're opening and closing the inside, hot, cold, to where you've positioned the lever. I mean, a little WD, he came out beautiful. He looks like he's brand new. This might require a brass brush.
Okay. Yeah, it was pretty good. I'm a firm believer in making sure everything where gaskets sit is clean. Go ahead and use a water brush. It'll fit in there. It'll clean it up. It doesn't have to be perfect. I just can't have anything in my way. Clean out the internals of that. I'll wipe it out real fast. Is there any clutter crap that was on here? It's now gone. I'm going to get the brush. I'm just going to hit right out here real fast. Nobody ever sees it. But since I have it off, I saw how nasty it was. The brush just takes it pretty much right away. That did too much damage because it made a brush. But I mean, look at the bottom. That's some scratching on stuff. It's swinging back and forth on the pots and pans in here. Take a little of this corner off. I mean, it's a sink, so perfection doesn't really matter. Unless it's you, it has to be perfect for me. Just trying to get better than it was. Get better than it was. Hey, as long as it doesn't leak. This. We need a nice flat surface here. It's brass on brass. I'm surprised there's no gasket here, but I think it might just be locked in the same place, the cartridge. Okay, so that's a nice flat surface.
I saw copper or anything with threads before I put it back together. I try to clean it up the best I can. It goes together better. Have less leaks in the end, because yes, I'm not a plumber, but I do HVAC, so I deal with water leaks all the time. Boilers love to leak. Get the cartridge, a little spray left, water run it all over. Now let's get them back together. Okay, he looks like he's pretty much good to go. I'm even gonna put grease onto these little rings here. My internal mechanism looks good. The set screw digs right into him. Okay. So now the first thing to go back on is my friction ring. They are identical, yes. This allows the sink to pivot. He's trying to hide in the gasket housing, so I don't want him in there. I'm going to use Super Seal anti-corrosive gel. Supposedly, I think I read on here somewhere. Oh, I thought it was food safe, but I guess not. It may cause skin and eye, read other... Oh, really? I thought in the past I read on one of them that they are actually... Wait, it's not. Okay, whatever. It's a gasket. I want the gasket to seal. Probably should use Vaseline instead, but whatever. Now, what I'm going to do before it gets into here, put this in the way. Of course, it's going to slide right around. Okay. Now, before I get low enough, put this into here. Okay, he's in. Now the next one. Pretty much have enough grease. It also helps break any crud or whatever's on him off. I'm surprised with how much crud was on this leaking. Now let's make sure the gasket is in a good place. Okay. Remember, that gasket has to seal on here. So, this has to be clean. There's the O-ring sealing on this and that. So, some of that crud in here isn't allowing a nice, good contact with the surface where nothing's in the way. Well, it's gonna leak, but I'm not a plumber, so maybe this is an overkill what I'm doing. I just don't like to do something and then have to do it again and again and again. Thank you. staying in place. Grease in here. Never hurt anybody. Grease. Okay. Now, we have this guy. Our switch. Not much because there's one freshen and liven up these gaskets, but not enough that it's going inside the mechanism. Okay. Now, can't see. Make sure I'm lining them up correctly. I gotta suck all this water out. Just dump and blow the suck. Great movie, Spaceballs! I can see inside. This is the only way you can sit. Yeah. Internal moves with that. This is just the switch. It's not gonna be a lot of torque, which is why I'm not holding all the way to the end. Okay. Too tight. It's like, no mercy! Make sure it's straight. Let's see if I go too tight. Am I not able to move it? Is that what happens? He moves. Okay, not very good, but he moves. Seems like it's out of place here. Very gently, this is plastic. I will probably take the chrome off if I try too hard to clean that. Okay. And this, I believe, locks this in place. So this is pretty important. And he locks that using these threads. So, yeah. Could my whole leak have been, it's just getting a little loose, then this is no longer like a solid seal. There's always that possibility. Crack. Okay, it's not moving anymore. Oh, I frigged up. Completely forgot this guy. Let's go. A little grease on him. This is a friction ring. This just helps him turn. Maybe even somehow, some weird way, like a compression, seals it. I don't know. I would have to study how this is supposed to work. But when you have water lines, you have that little compression ring inside there, that little friction compression ring, that when you tighten it, I even scratched them there, so shit happens. Now, I'm curious when I add water if he leaks without that. So, let's put the water on. And he would be on. Take this out real fast. WD cleans the sink better than all those crappy cleaners everybody else is using. And I do have a little leak here. This guy moves. I don't Okay, so now we have him here to take care of. Let's see what I can do with this thing. Because right now, he moves, he's a little loose, I tighten him, and I'm leaking from the top. I'm leaking from up here. So, I don't think I'm getting a good run here. First, turn the water on while we're here. My greasy gloves are having problems. Okay, we're on. Whew. Sink. He looks good. Seeing any water build up.
I think we have it.
And how about here? And we fix this leak. Nothing's making its way through. Now we can put the handle back on. Set screw. I'm turning it, nothing is leaking. Nope. Oh no, we got a little bit. All the grease comes off of them. I'm thinking, oh, that's little tiny bit right there isn't actually, would probably leak out of most sinks if you're putting pressure on them, because he doesn't leak like this. But I have noticed maybe we'll find there or there some pressurizes them up and down a little tiny bit. Am I going out and buying a new fitting, or did I just seal it? Perfect. Oh, thanks for watching my video. If you like what you've seen, hit like. And subscribe if you want to see more.